Om Ajnanatimarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripasindubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're going through the Krishna book and we're up to chapter number 87, the prayers by the personified Vedas.
我们现在继续读这个《快乐的源泉》（ （Krishna Book），提到了87章，伟达经人格化身的祈祷。
So the prayers, these prayers of the Vedas personified, it shows that the Vedas are meant to help us to understand Krishna.
那个伟达经人格化身的祈祷，能够让我们帮助我们去了解和认识 Krishna。
The Vedas are meant to help us to understand Krishna.
这个伟达经的一本身的意思就是帮助我们去了解 Krishna。
And all the personified Vedas,
所有伟达经的人格。
They're known as the Shrutis.
他们被誉为 Shruti。
There's two kinds of scriptures. One is the Smriti and the other is the Shruti.
有两种经典，一种经典被誉为 Smriti，圣传经，一个是 Shruti 神训经。
The Smriti is the things like the Puranas and the Mahabharata.
Smriti 比如说是。往事书、宇宙古史和 Mahabharata，伟大的帕拉达。
But the Shrutis, that's only the four Vedas.
这个 Shruti 专指的是伟达经。
And in the Vedas, of course, you have all the Upanishads and you have many other things.
这个 Shruti 就指的是奥义书和其他的一些经典。
So all these personified Vedas, they're all chanting about the glories of Lord Krishna.
这也说伟大的人格，他们都在唱诵主 Krishna 的荣耀。
So this shows us that the Lord is the most glorious.
所以这显示出主是最值得荣耀的。
And of all of the glories of the Lord, the most important is His mercy.
而在主的所有的这些最荣耀当中，最重要的是他的仁慈。
And His mercy is causeless, and it's given to the conditioned souls.
对，他这个仁慈是无缘的，没有缘故的，专门赐予给受条件限制的灵魂的。
And it helps to it brings them out from Maya.
把我们带出玛雅。
So there are an unlimited number of living entities in different varieties of bodies.
在不同的种类的身体中，有无限的数不胜数的生物体。
Some are moving and some are standing in one place.
有些是移动的，有些是在一个地方站立的。
Right, they're like the trees and the plants, they stand in one place.
就像树和植物在一个地方站立。
But the other living entities, the animals, the humans, and so on, they're moving.
其他呢，就像那些动物啊和人类，他们是移动的。
So the living entities are in conditioned life. Because they've forgotten their eternal relationship with Krishna.
所以这些受制约的这些生物呢，他们遗忘了与 Krishna 的永恒的关系。
So when the living entity wants, when he wants to lord over the material energy,
所以当生物想要主宰物质能量的时候，
then he imitates the position of Krishna.
他们模仿 Krishna 的地位。
So at that time, he immediately is captured by the material energy.
那么他们立即被物质能量所俘获。
And depending on his desire, is offered different kind of body in the 8,400,000 different kinds of bodies.
所以根据他们的欲望，他们被赐予840万种不同种类身体中的一个。
So he undergoes the three different kinds of miseries of material existence.
因而承受物质存在的三重苦。
But still, he thinks himself that he's the master of the world.
但他仍然认为自己是世界的主人。
He's under the spell of the material energy.
他们处在物质能量的钳制之下。
The material energy is there in the form of the three material qualities.
哎，这个物质能量呢，以这个物质的三种品质来展示出来。
So the living entity cannot get free from the material energy.
所以这个生物无法从物质能量中给摆脱出来。
The only way he can get free is by the grace of the Supreme Lord.
唯一摆脱的方法是藉着 Krishna 的仁慈才行。
The living entity cannot overcome the influence of the material nature.
生物无法征服物质自然的影响。
At least not by his own effort, she cannot conquer the material energy.
只靠自己的努力，没法挣脱物质自然的影响。
The material energy is working under the control of the Supreme Lord.
这物质能自然是在至尊主的控制下来运作。
And the Lord, he's above the material nature.
而主呢，超越这个物质资源，在物质资源之上。
The Lord is never affected by the material nature.
主是不受物质资源影响。
But except for Krishna, except for the Lord, all living entities, from Brahma down to the tiny insect, are conquered by the material nature.
除了 Krishna 之外，主之外，所有生物，上至 Brahma， 下至昆虫，都受物质资源的所控制、征服。
Oh, wait. Guru Mani, give a daddy more.
Oh. 他有没有在看看？
我不知道。Okay, because the Lord has all the six opulences in full.
主 Krishna 拥有全然的六种富裕。
He has all the wealth.
他有这种财富的富裕。
He has all the strength.
他有所有的力量。
He has all the fame.
他有所有的名声。
He has the beauty.
他有所有的美丽。
He has the knowledge.
所有的知识。
And he has the renunciation.
还有气绝。
So the Lord is complete. He has got everything.
所以主是完整的，他拥有一切。
He is above the spell of the material nature.
所以他超越于物质自然的这种控制和钳制。
If the living entity is in Krishna consciousness, then,
如果是,
then if he's not in Krishna consciousness, he cannot approach the Supreme Lord.
如果生物不处在 Krishna 自觉中的话，他无法接近 Krishna.
But the Lord Krishna has all potency.
但是 Krishna 是全能的。
So he can say from within the heart as a super soul, he can guide the living entity.
对，他以超灵居住在众生的心中，他给灵魂自己灵魂来指导。
And he can help the living entity to come to him.
对，他指导这个生物来去接近他。
Even when he's doing his ordinary work.
即使他从事于普通的工作。
And just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says,
就像在 Bhagavad Gita, 薄伽梵歌中 Krishna 说,
It says, whatever you do, do it for me.
无论你做什么,为我做。
And whatever you eat, first offer it to me.
无论你吃什么,你首先供奉给我。
And whatever charity you want to give, first give it to me.
无论你想布施什么，首先给我布施。
Whatever austerities and penances you want to perform, do them for me.
无论你做什么苦行和忏悔，你为我而做。
So in this way, even the karmis are.They're gradually guided to become Krishna conscious.
如果这样做，即使一位 karmi 功利性活动者，也被指导逐渐的去发展 Krishna 知觉。
So Krishna guides the philosophers to approach him.
所以，同样 Krishna 也在指导哲学家们去接近他。
He guides them to come to him gradually.
是逐渐的。指导他们接近他。
And he helps them to make a distinction between what is the Brahman and what is Maya.
所以也能逐渐的让他们区别什么是 Brahman, 梵，什么是 Maya。
And when their knowledge is mature, then at that time the living entity surrenders to Krishna.
当他的知识变得成熟的时候，那个时候他开始自愿臣服 Krishna 了。
And Krishna says this also in the Bhagavad Gita.
Krishna 在 Bhagavad Gita 薄伽梵歌也是这么说的。
It says, after many births, the wise philosopher surrenders to Krishna.
经历很多的出生之后，真正聪明的、有智慧的哲学家会自愿臣服我。
And the yogis are also told to concentrate their meditation upon Krishna in the heart.
所以这个瑜伽师 yogi 们也被教导，也被教授，要全神贯注于，把他们的冥想专注于心中的 Krishna.
And by practicing like that, by practicing Krishna consciousness like this, they can also.Get free from the material nature.
所以通过这种这不断的这种程序去修炼这个 Krishna 自觉的程序，他们就会摆脱物质自然的能量。
But devotees are a bit different. Devotees are different from the karmis and the gyanis.
那奉献者就不一样了，奉献者跟 karmi 物质功利性活动者和 gyani 思辨家就不一样了，情况是不一样的。
The devotees they just simply engage in devotional service with love and devotion.
奉献者只是怀着爱和情感去直接为 Krishna 做奉献服务。
And from the very beginning, they have a relationship with Krishna.
所以刚从开始, 奉献者就跟Krishna建立了一种关系。
And Krishna personally guides them.
完了, Krishna本人亲自来指导他们。
And he helps them to approach him without difficulty.
帮助他们毫无困难地去接近他。
So this is described also in the Bhagavad Gita.
这《薄伽梵歌》中也描述了这一点。
Krishna says, it's only by the grace of Krishna that the living entity can understand the position of the Brahman and Paramatma and Bhagavan.
通过Krishna主的仁慈, 生物能够明白 Brahman 梵的地位, Paramatma 超灵的地位 和 Bhagavan 薄伽梵的地位。
So all the words of the personified Vedas, all the teachings of the personified Vedas give evidence about the Vedic literature.
所以呢, 这些都是伟达经的人格化身, 给出了清晰的这种清明的这个证据。
They show that the Vedas is only presenting information to help us understand Krishna.
只有伟达的一线能够清晰的，能够只有这种文献能让人了解理解 Krishna.
And the Bhagavad Gita confirms the same thing as all the Vedas.
所以巴嘎给的薄伽梵歌也验证了证实了所有伟达经所说的。
Bhagavad Gita says it's only Krishna who has to be understood.
伟达经说, 唯一要了解的只是Krishna.
And Krishna's always enjoying.
Krishna永远在享乐, 享受,
either in the material world or in the spiritual world.
无论Krishna在物质世界还是在灵性世界, 他永远在享乐。
He is the supreme enjoyer.
因为他是至尊的享受者。
And for Krishna, there's no difference between the material and the spiritual world.
对Krishna而言, 物质世界和灵性世界没有区别。
So the material world, it's a problem for the ordinary living entities.
物质世界对普通的生物而言确实是个困难，是个障碍。
Because the living entities in the material world, they're under the control of the material nature.
因为物质世界里的生物处在物质自然的控制之下。
But Krishna is the supreme controller. He's the controller of the material world.
但是 Krishna 是至尊控制者，他是物质世界的控制者。
So he doesn't have anything to do with the problems which are facing the living entities.
所以这个对生物来说所面临的困难，对 Krishna 来说一点关系都没有。
So in different places in the Upanishads, the Vedas explain this.
所以根据不同的这个奥义书的各个部分，伟达经就描述了。They
explained that the Supreme Brahman is eternal, full of knowledge and bliss.
所以他说到至尊法满，至尊法是永恒的，充满所有的知识和所有的喜乐。So
the Supreme Lord exists in the heart of every living entity.
这至尊人格首人 临在于每一个生物的心中,
and he's everywhere in everything.
他无所不在, 临在于万事万物之中。
He is able to enter into the heart of the living entities.
他能进入每个生物的心中。
And he can enter also into every atom.
他甚至进入每个原子之中。
And he's the super soul, so he's the controller of all the activities of the living entity.
他是超灵, 他是所有生物活动的控制者。
So he's within everyone, and so he sees their actions.
所以他临在于每个人生物之内，见证着所有人的活动。
And he allows them to act according to their desire.
他根据每个人的欲望，允许他们去活动。
And he gives them the results of their different activities.
然后给予他们不同活动的结果，赐予给他们。
So he is the living force of everything.
他是万事万物的生命力。
But he is transcendental to the material qualities.
但是呢，他又超然于物质的品质。
He has all the different potencies.
他有不同的能量。
He is expert. He's expert to make. He can produce anything.
他特擅长制造万事万物。
And because of his.Because he has so much knowledge, he can bring everyone under his control.
因为他具有所有这些知识，他能把每个人置于他的自己的控制之下。
So he is everybody's master.
因为他是众生的主人。
And sometimes he appears on the surface of the globe.
它有时显现在地球的表面。
But at the same time, he's also within all the matter.
同时呢，它又处在每个物质之中。
He can expand himself in many unlimited forms.
它扩展以无限的形象扩展自己。
He just glanced over the material energy, and all the living entities became manifest.
他只是瞥视了一下物质能量，所有数不胜数的生物便展示出来，扩展出来。
So everything is created by his energy.
所以一切都是通过他的能量被创造出来。
And everything in his creation.
Appears. 一切都在他的创造之内。
Everything in his creation is perfect.
他创造的一切呢，还都是完美。
There's no deficiency in any.
没有任何的缺陷。
So people who want liberation from this material world, they have to worship the Supreme Lord.
所以无论谁想要从这个物质世界解脱出去的话，他必须要崇拜至尊的首相。
The Lord is the cause. He's the highest cause of all causes.
他是所有原因的最高的原因。
He's just like the total mass of Earth.
他就像一个这个total mass.
Yeah, he's like all the Earth, he's like the whole Earth planet.
就像这个地球，它是。地球的全部。
So from the earth, from the ground on the planet, then we can make many different varieties of pots.
就像从这个地表的土中，我们可以制造各种各样的土罐。
And the pots are made, they're made of the clay.
它们由这个泥土组成了这些泥罐。
And they rest, they at the same time they stand on the earth, they rest on the earth.
同时他们依靠这个土。
And after they're broken, then all the clay goes back into the earth again.
而这个罐呢被打破之后，这罐的那个本身制造成分又重新融回于土中。
The earth is the original cause of all the varieties.
所以这土啊，就是所有这个展示的多种多样展示的最初的原因。
In the same way, the Lord is the cause of all varieties in the material world.
所以呢，同样，主是所有物质展示中的终极的原因，最高的原因。
So the impersonalists, they also use this analogy.
所以啊，那个分格主义者他也运用了这个比喻，类比。
They also use this analogy about the earth and they compare it to Brahman.
所以，他分格主义者也把这个，以土的例子，把它比喻为这个 Brahman 梵。
Because in the Vedas there's a statement that says, Sarvam Kalv Idam Brahma. Everything is Brahman.
因为伟达经也说过，Sarvam Kalv Idam Brahman，万事万物都是 Brahman 梵。
So the impersonalists, they do not like to take, they do not like to admit there's varieties in the world.
所以，这分格主义者不是那么喜欢用这种创造的丰富多彩。
They don't admit that the many varieties are coming from the Supreme Brahman.
他们不喜欢用这种什么丰多姿多彩的展示，流言于自尊的原因，而慢。
But they will say everything comes from Brahman.
他们喜欢说万事万物都流源自 Brahman，
And after it's destroyed, it all goes back into Brahman.
那么一切摧毁毁灭之后，又都融进于 Brahman 之中。
And they say that in between these two stages, that is also Brahman.
而他们说，在这种展示的中间的地带呢，它也是 Brahman。
So the Mayavadis believe that before the manifestation, this world was in Brahman.
所以呢，Mayavadi 们他们相信，在这个展示之前呢，宇宙也是处在曾经处在 Brahman 之中。
And then after the world is created, it remains in Brahman.
而这个世界创造之后呢，它还存在于 Brahman 之中。
And after it's destroyed, it goes back into Brahman.
而且毁灭之后呢，它又融进 Brahman 之中。
So they do not know what Brahman is.
他们不知道 Brahman 到底是何物。
But the Brahma Samhita, the prayers of Lord Brahma, they clearly describe Brahman.
而这个Brahma 的祈祷 Brahma Samhita 中，清晰地描述了 Brahman 是什么。
Yeah, the Brahma Samhita says that the living
Brahma Samhita，
entities space, the living entities space, time, and the material elements.
Brahma Samhita 中说，生物、空间、时间和物质元素。
They're like fire and earth and sky and water and mind.
这物质元素好比如土、火、空气、天空、水、心意。
And they make up the total form of the material world.
他们总共组成了宇宙展示的总体。
In Sanskrit, they're known as Bhu, Bhuva, and Swa.
梵文叫做 Bhu, Bhuva, Swaha。
And they're manifested by, they all come from Govinda.
他们都来自于 Govinda。
And the whole manifestation of the material world is on the strength of Govinda.
所有的物质乃是都依赖于狗瘟的力量。
And after it's destroyed, it enters into and it's kept there by Govinda.
所以毁灭之后，它要融进狗瘟的之中，由狗瘟的来保持。
So Lord Brahma says, I worship Lord Govinda, the original personality. the cause of all causes.
所以主布拉玛说，我崇拜原始的主，高温的万源之源。
So the word Brahman, it shows that the it tells us about the greatest of all.
所以这个 Brahman 梵这个词，说明是所有一切中最伟大的。
And the maintainer of everything.
也还有另外意思，万事万物的维系者。
So the impersonalists, they are attracted by the greatness of the sky.
所以分格主义者被这个天空的伟大所吸引。
But because they don't have much knowledge, they are not attracted by the greatness of Krishna.
但是由于他们没有知识，他们没有被 Krishna 的伟大所吸引。
So in our life, we are attracted by the greatness of a person.
在我们的生活中，我们被一个人的伟大所吸引。
We're not so much attracted by the greatness of a big mountain.
我们不会被这个高山的伟大所吸引。
So the word Brahman means Krishna, and it refers to Krishna.
这 Brahman 这个词实际上指的就是 Krishna.
And in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says that Brahman is the supreme Brahman.
就在 Bhagavad Gita 中说，主 Krishna 是至尊的 Brahman， 至尊梵。
And he is Lord Krishna himself is the resting place of everything.
所以 Krishna 本人是万事万物的栖息之地。
So Krishna is the supreme Brahman because he has unlimited knowledge.
所以 Krishna 是至尊梵，至尊 Brahman， 因为他有无限的知识。
And he has unlimited potencies.
他也有无限的能力。
He has unlimited strength.
有无限的力量。
Unlimited influence.
无限的影响力。
Unlimited beauty.
无限的美丽。
And unlimited renunciation.
和无限的弃绝。
Therefore, the word Brahman can only be applied to Krishna.
因此Brahman 梵这个词只能运用到 Krishna 身上。
So Arjuna, he says that the impersonal Brahman is the effulgence coming from the body of Krishna.
所以 Arjuna 确认这个非人格 Brahman 是流自于 Krishna 身体的光芒，超然身体的光芒。
Krishna's body is transcendental.
Krishna's 身体是超然的。
He is the supreme Brahman.
他是至尊梵，至尊的 Brahman.
So everything rests on Brahman.
万事万物都栖息在 Brahman 之中。
But Brahman rests on Krishna.
但 Brahman 本身却依靠 Krishna.
So Krishna is the ultimate Brahman.
所以 Krishna 是至尊终极的 Brahman，
the Para Brahman，
梵文叫 Para Brahman。
So the material elements are the inferior energy of Krishna。
所以物质元素被誉为 Krishna 的低级的能量。
And by their interaction, the material world comes into being。
所以通过与物质的与展示相融合才成为物质世界。
And that whole creation rests on Krishna.
所有这些创造都依靠 Krishna.
And after it's destroyed, it all enters into the body of Krishna.
所以当它再次物质世界被溶解之后，它再次进入了 Krishna 的身体之中。
It enters as subtle energy.
以精微的能量进入了 Krishna 的身体。
So Krishna is the cause of both creation and destruction.
所以 Krishna 既是扩展也是溶解的原因。
So the Vedas say Sarvam Kalp Idam Brahma.
Krishna 说 Sarvam Kalp Idam Brahma.
That means that everything is Krishna.
他的意思，万事万物都是 Krishna.
Everything is Krishna's energy.
万事万物都是 Krishna 的能量。
So that is the vision of the Mahabhagavatas.
这就是 Mahabhagavata 的视域。
They see everything in relation to Krishna.
他们看到万事万物都跟 Krishna 相连。
The impersonalists, they say that Krishna has been changed into, Krishna has been changed into many other things.
对非个主义者争辩说 ,Krishna 本人已经被转变成很多很多其他的东西了。
So they say everything is Krishna.
所以他们才说万事万物都是 Krishna。
And they say we can worship anything. That's worship of Krishna.
所以他们说你可以崇拜任何东西都是在崇拜 Krishna。
So this is a wrong argument.
这是一个错误的论点。
And this is explained by Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita.
而这一点由 Krishna 在 Bhagavad Gita 薄伽梵歌中已经解释了。
Although we can say it's true, everything is the energy of Krishna.
对，万事万物都是 Krishna 能量，这一点是正确的。
But Krishna is not personally present everywhere.
但是 Krishna 本人并不临在于万事万物中。
He at the same time he's present, but he's not present.
Krishna 同时临在，同时又不临在。
By his energy, he's present everywhere.
通过他的能量，他无所不在，临在于各处。
But as the energetic means the source of the energy, he is not present everywhere.
但是他作为能量的源头，能量拥有者，他不临在于，万事万物中。
So at the same time, he's present and not present.
所以他同时临在又不临在。
So this is inconceivable to our senses.
以我们目前的感知力来说，这是不可思议的事情。
But a clear explanation is given.In the beginning of the Ishopanishad.
在至尊奥义书 Ishopanishad 的开始给出了清晰的解释。
In the Ishopanishad, it says that the Supreme Lord is complete.
在至尊奥义书中说，至尊主 Krishna 是完整的，是完全的。
And the Lord has unlimited energies.
他有无限的能量。
And these energies are all coming from Krishna.
而这些能量都来自流源自 Krishna.
But Krishna personally, he doesn't change.
但 Krishna 本人没有变化。
So Krishna is the cause of all causes.
所以 Krishna 是万源之源。
So intelligent people,They should take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna.
所以有智者，有智慧的人应该托庇于 Krishna 的莲花中。
So Krishna advises everyone just to surrender to him.
所以 Krishna 忠告每个人，只是自愿臣服他就够了。
That is the Vedic instruction.
这就是。伟达经的训示和教导。
So Krishna is the cause of all causes.
因为 Krishna 是万源之源。
So he is worshipped by all kinds of sages and saints.
所 所以他受到所有种类的圣人们的崇拜。
And they will observe all the regulative principles to worship him.
所以他们遵守所有的规范原则来崇拜他。
And for meditation, great personalities will meditate on the form of Krishna.
在冥想中，伟大的人物都冥想着 Krishna 的超然形体。
They will meditate on him within the heart.
他们在心中来冥想。
So this way, the minds of the great personalities are always thinking of Krishna.
所以通过这样，伟大人物的心意总是专注于 Krishna。
And for the devotees, because they are always always thinking of Krishna, they always talk about Krishna.
对奉献者来说呢，奉献者经常冥想，心意中想着 Krishna， 他们只是谈论有关 Krishna 的东西。
So talking about Krishna or singing of Krishna, this is kirtan.
谈论 Krishna。歌唱 Krishna 被称为 Kirtan。
So Lord Chaitanya recommends Kirtan Sadahari, always chant the holy name.
主 Chaitanya 推荐到 Kirtaniya Sadahari, 始终唱诵 Krishna。
Always thinking about Krishna and talking of Krishna, nothing else.
始终想着 Krishna， 始终谈论 Krishna， 从此别无他事可做。
This is Krishna consciousness.
这就是 Krishna 知觉。
So Krishna consciousness is so nice that anyone comes to the highest stage of life.
所以 Krishna 知觉是如此的美好和崇高。任何接受这个程序的人就能达到生命的最高的完美境界。
They will come much higher than liberation.
这个境界比解脱要高得多了。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna tells everyone to always think of him.
所以在 Bhagavad Gita 薄伽梵空中 ，Krishna 忠告每个人要时常想着他。
And do devotional service to him.
为他做奉爱服务。
Worship him.
崇拜他。
Offer obeisances to him.
顶拜他。
So in this way, a devotee becomes fully Krishna conscious.
如此，奉献者就变得完全的 Krishna 化了。
And for sure, he will go back to Godhead, back to Krishna.
他肯定能够重返家园，回归 Krishna。
Now in the Vedas, it's also recommended worship of different demigods.
但是那个伟达经呢，又推荐了崇拜不同的半神人。
And the different demigods are like parts and parcels of Krishna.
不同的半神人好比 Krishna 不同的所属部分。
So this instruction to worship the demigods, this is meant for the less intelligent people.
而这个对拜神人的崇拜这个教导是给那些自信不足的人准备的。
It's for people who are still attached to sense enjoyment.
而这种人呢，仍然被物质的感官享乐所吸引。
But for the people who want perfect,who want perfection in the human life, they should simply worship Krishna.
而那些想要在人生使命中得到完美的人，他应该只是崇拜主 Krishna.
And that will guarantee the success of human life.
他们会得到保证，肯定此生大功告成。
So the sky, the water, and the land, they're all parts of the material world.
对，天空、水、陆地都是物质世界的所有的部分。
So when we stand on the land, our position is better than when we are standing in the sky or on the water.
当一个人站立在坚硬的土地上，他的处境要比他站在空中和水中要好，安全。
So in the same way, an intelligent person will not stand under the protection of different demigods.
所以有智慧、有自信的人肯定不让自己处在不同种类半神人的保护之下的。
The demigods are all part and parcel of Lord Krishna.
因为半神人也是 Krishna 的所属部分嘛。
But better is to stand on the solid ground of Krishna consciousness.
相反，他站在 Krishna 知觉这坚硬的地面上。
And then he's safe and secure.
这样他的地位就这样说，他的地位听起来就特别的安全。
So the impersonalists, they will give the example. Well, if we stand on a stone or a piece of wood, then when standing, it's just like standing on the land.
分格主义者有时也给一个例子说，如果一个人站在一块石头上或站在一个木头上，那就证明他肯定会站在这个陆地的表面上。
Because the stone and the wood, they're both on the ground.
因为这个石头和木头，它依靠的是这个地球的陆地的表面。
But we say, well, better to just stand on the ground. It will be more secure than standing on the wood or on the stone.
但我们说，直接站在陆地上比站在石头上和木头上更好，更安全。
So taking shelter of Paramatma or taking shelter of the impersonal Brahman is not as good as taking shelter of Krishna.
所以啊，你脱避于超灵 Paramatma， 你脱避于非人格 Brahman 犯，没有直接脱避 Krishna 更安全更好。
The Gyanis and the Yogis are not as secure as the devotee of Krishna.
所以这个伽尼思辨家 Yogi 瑜伽师的地位可没有 Krishna 的奉献者的地位那么安全。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says that if only when a person has lost his senses does he worship the demigods.
所以 Krishna 在薄伽梵文中说，只有那些失去 理智的人才去崇拜半神人。
And for people who are attached to the impersonal Brahman, then the Srimad Bhagavatam says something else.
而那些脱避于非人格 Brahman 的人，薄伽瓦坛说了几句话。
The Srimad Bhagavatam says that those who think of themselves as liberated by mental speculation, they're not really purified.
那些认为自己已经解脱了，通过心智推敲而解脱的人，他们实际上并没有得到净化。
They're still contaminated by the material nature.
他们还在受物质自然的污染。
Because they haven't taken the shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord.
因为他们没有能力能找到对主的莲花足的托庇。
So they may come to the transcendental position of Brahman.
他们即使被提升到了这个 Brahman 的超然的地位。
But they fall down from that position.
他们也会从那个地位中堕落下来。
Because they haven't taken the shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord.
因为他们没有脱避于主的莲花足而导致堕落。
So people who worship the demigods are not very intelligent.
所以崇拜半神人的人，缺心眼的人，没有自信的人。
They get only temporary benefit.
他们只得到短暂的好处。
So they are not very intelligent people.
他们是一批不怎么聪明的人。
But the devotee, Lord Krishna says, my devotee has no fear of falling.
而 Krishna 说，他的奉献者根本就没有堕落的恐惧。
Okay, so we'll stop here today.
今天我们就到这儿。
Are there any questions?
有什么问题吗？
There were four questions on Tuesday morning. Are those questions there?
那个，今天上午有四个问题。昨天还是今天？
星期二早上。
星期二。
是的，是的。等，稍等一下，我马上。
小小，顶拜咕噜，感谢翻译。请问您，让我们只崇拜 Krishna， 而大陆有些奉献者家里有事情，就去圣地做祭祀，可不可以？这个推荐可以这么做吗？
对，是什么？
他说，比如说是我们家里有一些事情，我们就要在圣地找主尼星哈做祭祀啊。If there has something happened in our family, be something like that, we offer or we always do some yagya to the such as Lord Ni Singha Dev.
So what's the question? 他的问题。
可不，对，可不可以这样？我有。
可以，可是。The best thing to do is to surrender to Krishna.
你这样做可以，但最好呢，你要臣服，自愿臣服 Krishna， 这个更好。
Doing the ritual, doing some ritual. That's helping devotion, but you know.You're only coming to Krishna when you have a problem. We should worship Krishna every day. You should worship Lord Nrisimhadev every day, not just when you have problems.
这个仪式啊，会帮助你的奉爱。但我们修这个 Krishna， 你来崇拜 Krishna， 我们应该天天去崇拜 Krishna 和尼星哈，而不是有问题了、家里有事了，你再去做祭祀、崇拜主、崇拜 Krishna， 崇拜主尼星哈，你要天天去崇拜。
So your worship of Krishna is motivated by your material problems.
你崇拜 Krishna 是清除你的物质，要清除你的物质的这个问题。
So yes, you can do that, but it's not pure devotion.
你可以这么做，家里有事儿去圣地做祭祀，但这个不是纯粹的奉爱，不是纯粹的 bhakti。
You should think, you should want to worship Lord Nrisimhadev every day or pray to the Lord every day.
你应该每天持续的崇拜主尼星哈，每天都要向他祈祷。
You do some ritual.
有一些仪式。
These rituals are helping you to develop faith in the Lord.
这个仪式啊，会帮助你对主有信心。
So you should think how to get, you should think how to get eternal benefit from the Lord.
你应该想怎么能从主那里得到一种永恒的利益、永恒的好处。下一个问题吗？
呀。
顶拜咕噜，顶拜翻译，请问我们中国奉献者读经典祷文时不会英语， 只读中文，这样可不可以取悦主？
Definitely. Krishna can speak all the languages.
你肯定能取悦主，因为主懂所有的语言，就中文他也懂。
Krishna can speak even the language of the birds.
Krishna 能说鸟语。
Krishna can speak, he can understand all the languages. You don't have to worry.
Krishna 能懂所有的语言，所以你休要担心，不要害怕，不用担心这事。
A devotee who translates, there was one devotee in Hong Kong, he translated the Bhagavad Gita, the very first edition of the Bhagavad Gita.
在香港有个奉献者，他翻译了 Bhagavad Gita in the dictionary.
The very first one, the very first edition, Yashomati Sutta, Prabhupada disciple.
Yes, ah.这早期的一个泡泡的那个门徒亚苏玛提，他发现了第一批的那个薄伽梵歌。
So he brought it to Prabhupada, gave to Prabhupada, and Prabhupada asked him. He said, "Read it. I want to hear it. I want to hear you read the Bhagavad Gita in Chinese to me."
然后呢，他把这个第一个翻译、第一个版本就送给了泡泡德。泡泡说：“我想让你读，给我读这个第一版本的中文的薄伽梵歌。”
So Yashomati, he's a Hong Kong, he's a Hong Kong man. So he read it in Cantonese, you know, and he was reading it, and Prabhupada was saying, "Oh, very nice, very sweet."
然后呢，Yashomati 是在是香港嘛，他都用种白话，或者他给泡泡读，泡泡听了他以后就说，啊，太好听了，哎，太甜美了。
So Prabhupada was also appreciating the beauty of the Bhagavad Gita in Chinese.
泡泡在欣赏薄伽梵歌中文版的那种甜美啊。
Okay.
下一个是 Kesava Priya. 如何改正我自己的缺点？我有缺点，如何 remove the how to correct my shortcoming， 课中讲到，所有的问题都是因为我的心意，只是念诵就可以改变我的心意或所有的问题，还是先有语言说话行为上的改变，然后才能改变呢？
So she wants to correct all her faults. One way is,
yes.
She says by chanting the holy name.
The chanting the whole name first, or the first, I have to change my behavior or my how to talk. First, change my languages, change my behavior, or I should first improve my chanting.
Well, with your, yes, both they go together, you know.They both don't go together. That as you're chanting, then your behavior should also improve.
Okay. 姑说呢，你要改变这些缺点，你念诵和语言行为的改变要同时进行。你念诵，你的行为也要有所改变才行。
A devotee of Krishna should have all the good qualities.
Krishna 的奉献者，你修 Krishna 同时你的行为要有好的品质。
So you have to be patient and you have to keep chanting and also keep trying to improve yourself. It takes time to change.
所以你要有耐心，你要念诵和行为改变是需要时间的。
Previously,You didn't know you had faults. You thought you were a very good. You thought everything was perfect, but gradually we become more aware that I have these faults. I have this problem.
在修慧生之前呢，你没觉得自己有什么缺点， 你觉得自己很完美，觉得自己很不错。现在你终于知道了，你自己还有缺点。
So you can work on trying to improve yourself as a person.
所以呢，你现在呢，正在努力的改善、提高自己，成为一个完美的人。下一个，尤瓦提·韦萨卡，顶拜孤儿莲花族，在网上启迪的奉献者，没有孤儒给的启迪念珠，就怎么办呢？我用佛教念的珠念可以吗？他还没有得到启迪念珠，所以在网上启迪以后怎么办？So what to do? I have not
Well,
Japa drink.
you should tell to the spiritual teacher, and he will arrange to send beads for you.
那你就告诉一下你的启迪咕噜，我要启迪咕噜给你优启迪念珠。
Just now, I'm in Malaysia, and there's a lot of Chinese devotees here from many places, so I can give beads to them, and they can get them to you.
就像在马来西亚有很多来的中国奉献者，那么你告诉我呢，我就可以把启迪念珠给他，让他带回去给您就行了。
But who is your guru?
You Maharaj, you are T Vaisakha
Oh,
from Paisan, Paisan.
Yuvati Vishaka, Bai Chang.
Yes, 不是他，maybe her mother.
哦，他的妈妈。
Yes, no Japa beads.
Oh, okay. So, okay,
And
well.
Yadu 还叫什么？Yadu right？Two.
Two people, eh?
She needs two,
All
not
right.
one.
Okay, 2个人, huh?
Yes.
Okay, Bai Chang, huh?
Yes.
So I'll give them to somebody, maybe somebody from Beijing, and then they can send them by, quite, they
OK，
can.
那个姑说，她可以把这个两个念珠给北京的，北京通过快递呀什么的邮给你。
Yeah, quite easy. You can get. So, Yuvati Vishaka. Bai Chang.
Yes.
Okay, Liangarin. Okay, well, KG. Well, I want that.
下一个啊，我念诵。做服务时，总是冥想 Guru 和 Krishna，我就充满了力量，非常的专注，这让我感觉特别甜美。我就努力的想这么做，带着这样的知觉，我这样做可以让我的心意净化吗？想着 Guru，meditate on Guru and Krishna。While I'm doing the devotional service, is that make me purified with
Yes,
this concept?
very
可以
good.
的，这样做可以让你的心意得到净化。下一个问题，咕噜，我早上上班路上。摔破了膝盖，我膝盖 knees and I knees maybe smart
Broke the knee, cracked
yes 对，这样
injured knee.
我顶拜神像的时候，我的膝盖很疼，那这样的事情是不是 Krishna 在考验我呀？我应该怎么以什么样的心态去面对这些？这是不是 Krishna 的考验？
Well, there's different ways in which you can offer obeisances. It's not just only with the body. You can also offer obeisances in the mind, and you can also offer with words.
那个，你顶拜神像不一定用身体来顶拜，你可以用心意来顶拜，你可以用语言来顶拜，不一定用身体，
So, because you're
跪着顶拜。
You've injured your knee, you're not able to bend down very easily. So you offer obeisances in the mind and with words.
因为你的膝盖摔疼了嘛，要顶拜不是那么容易，那你就用心意和语言去顶拜就可以了。 那这样的事情是不是 Krishna 在考验我呢？
Well, yeah, you can say everything is a test from Krishna. Yes.
你可以说我们生活中发生的每件事都是 Krishna 的考验。
We're always tested. The ultimate test comes at the end of life.
最终极的考验是临终之前，死亡的时候。
So it's all preparation for the final test.
所以我们为了临终时要为了临终那一刻要做好准备。
Okay.
Okay. 这有最后一个问题，我不知道这个，我看应该怎么翻译的。他说顶拜 Guru 和翻译，我的问题是。我看一下。我的问题是，我没有视家人为陌生人，但是家人视我为陌生人，我困惑不已，如何调整 ？I don't see my family as strangers yet, but my family sees me as a stranger. I'm confused how to adjust the mentality.
Well, you have to be patient and you have to be personal also.
你要有耐心，还要有具有点人格。
And you have to show some interest in your family.
你要对你的家人有一些兴趣啊。
Yeah, you have to connect to them and you have to show that you care about them.
你要关心他们，你要跟他们有联系，不要置之不理他们。
So yeah, remember we're persons. Our philosophy is personal. Don't be impersonal.
所以我们是人，我们是有人格的。我们讲的哲学是人格的，不是非人格的。
So even though your family may not be devotees, but still they're your family. So you should take care of them, be concerned for them.
所以你的家人虽然不是奉献者，但是他们也是人，你需要关心他们。去关爱他们，关注他们，还要照顾他们。
Yeah, you have to see Krishna's in their heart also.
你也要在他们心中看到 Krishna 的临在。
So remember, they're also part and parcel of Krishna.
要记住，他们也是 Krishna 的所属部分。
And you have a relationship with them in the family.
所以你在家庭中跟他们还是有关系的。
Okay, Charu Maya has her hand up. Charu Maya.
Hare Krishna. 顶拜亲爱的古贝的莲花族，我有个问题想问一下，就是奉献者看待万事万物都是 Krishna 的能量，非奉献者看到万事万物是 Krishna。但你刚才讲的以我们现在的脑袋是无法了解 Krishna， 是不是我们只是服务 Krishna， 不用去想怎么样去了解 Krishna 呢？
他说just you said everything is Krishna， Krishna is in everything， but we cannot see thatSo that means we should not try to understand that. We only engage ourselves in the devotional service of the Lord. That is enough. Is that right?
Well, if we have to understand that devotional service to the Lord is to understand that the Lord is within everyone.
如果我们从事这个奉爱服的话，对主从事奉爱服的话，我们也应该知道 ，Krishna 在万事万物中。
You cannot just think, "Oh, I just serve Krishna," and you don't see Krishna in the heart of everyone. That's not good.
但你不能说我只服务 Krishna， 但是我可看不到 Krishna 在众生的心中，一切的一切人的心中，这我看不着，我就服就行了。这个还不行。
We have to see everyone in relation to Krishna.
我们还要看到每个人都跟 Krishna 有关系，相连。
So that, yeah, it, because devotional service is relating to Bhagavan. So Bhagavan, if you know Bhagavan, you should also know Brahman, and you should also know Paramatma.
So we see that service is related to Bhagavan, but related to Bhagavan, you also have to know Brahman, you also have to know Paramatma, Chaoling.
Brahman and Paramatma are also part of Krishna.
那个 Brahman 和 Paramatma 超灵也是 Krishna.
So one who knows Krishna will also know the Brahman and Paramatma.
所以你知道了 Krishna, 你也就知道了 Brahman 和超灵。
Just like somebody has 100 RMB,They also have 50 RMB, they also have 20 RMB.
就像一个人有100块钱人民币，他同时就有了50块钱和20块钱。
Everything is in the 100. So everything is in Krishna. Brahman and Paramatma are also in Krishna.
所以这几十块钱都在100元中，同样 Brahman, 超灵也都在 Krishna 中。
So you say you're serving Krishna,You have to also understand that Krishna is present in other forms, in other places. It's not just only there in the deity, it's not just only there as Krishna, but he's in everyone, in everything.
所以呢，你不只是服务 Krishna, 你还要知道 Krishna 不只是 Krishna 有神像， Krishna 也以其他的不同的形体存临在于每个地方，临在于每个人心中，临在于万事万物中。
Understand, Jeremiah?
好的，听明白了，谢谢咕噜的仁慈。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Okay, 还有问题吗？没有。
没有了，咕噜的。
Okay, 我们感谢 Rajendra Prabhu 给我们整台的翻译，我们感谢所有的奉献者聆听，我们祝福你们晚安。Swan Jiao Shun Li, Wan Shi Ru Yi, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Joy.